Well, hello. So, welcome to Margarita's channel. I'm the beauty specialist, and today Margarita couldn't do the intro. When she can't do it, I'm always excited about that. And she's not here in spirits, unfortunately. It's a little too early to be having margaritas. Well, anyway, today is Bronze Goddess Look, and I'm excited about it because she is going to incorporate the latest drugstore makeup, all new products, and some of her Luxe makeup, of course. Now, if you want to see how she accomplishes mixing those two together, I'll see you on the other side.
We're back, and same old, with my beauty specialist here.
You know it. So, hey, y'all. That's what we're saying, South. Yeah. So today, luxury meets drugstore. So I'm excited about this video because it's going to be interesting to see how the two roll together. But it's going to be a good video. I'll stick around.
Okay, so just like my beauty specialist said, we will combine luxury makeup and drugstore makeup to create a bronze goddess look. Because for some reason, that is my favorite word on my YouTube channel. And before we start, I want you to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And please follow me on my Instagram and Facebook, both Margarita D. Wooten. And everything that we will discuss is in the description below if you're interested to pick it up.
Yeah.
Let's start. I just want to let you know that most of the products here are tested for a week or so, and some are new impressions. And I will start with a primer. The primer that I chose for this video is my favorite Tatcha, the Silk Canvas, because I have a new foundation and I used it for more than a week. So I tried what primer is the best for the foundation, and this is the one. So I will use this one, so I will get the finish that I want for today. And everyone knows that I love this one.
All right, so that's $52. So I imagine that's on the luxe side. but you know it's good stuff, though. It's a primer that's got a priming balm. It makes the makeup last longer and keeps it preventing clogging, pores, and breakout. So it's some good stuff right there. I like it.
Okay. If you don't want to spend $52, I know it's a lot for a primer. They have a travel size of $22. You know, if you just want to try it. For me, the reason why I chose this, because every time I use this, it's like a moisturizer and primer in one. And now we're ready for the foundation. The one that I'm featuring is this overhyped Catrice Skin Hydrating Foundation with Hyaluronic Acid Longwear. Looks like this. I'm in shade 40. I chose this. This is new drugstore. I tested it for more than a week, so I know that this is good. Let's start.
This is some hydrating foundation. It's long wearing. Vegan foundation with medium buildable coverage for a natural real skin finish.
Okay.
I like that. Yeah. It's hyaluronic.
Hyaluronic.
All right. Can't get that word right. Help skin retain moisturizer and keep it hydrated. So that's awesome good stuff too.
My beauty specialist is having a hard time pronouncing hyaluronic acid.
Yeah, you use that trouble too. It's all good.
I'm done applying the foundation and I love this foundation. It says in the website it's medium coverage, but actually it's full coverage.
That's
you
great.
Know, I even use a wet sponge and still full coverage. I have like, you know, discoloration here and there, and it covers everything. It's lightweight, and it's not for me. It's not for dry skin, and I have dry skin. That's why I put the Tatcha primer before I put this on, so it will look good all day. The next product that I will show you is this new Maybelline Perfector 4-in-1 Glow Makeup. When I saw this coming out, I got so excited. I said, yes, I want this. 4-in-1, they said it can be concealer, highlighter, foundation, illuminating, whatever. And I'm in a light beige, 01.
Hey, this is $12.99. So I'd say that's on the drugstore side. All right, so it's instant age, rewinding, instant perfection, 4-in-1 glow makeup. Primes, conceals, highlights, and even skin tones with light coverage.
This is one of those that is first impression, and it's glowy, but it has no coverage. I don't like it as a concealer. I like it maybe as a like mix with foundation to make your foundation glowy. It looks good in the monitor.
It looks great on your skin. $12.99.
But it doesn't. It has no coverage. So I will just use my first love. It's still Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Corrector Multi-Usage. Yeah. This is full coverage. Look.
It's full coverage under eye concealer. Erases dark circles and fine lines. It diminishes puffiness.
What I will do is I will mix them because, you know, I don't want to look cakey.
And that is $9.99.
Yeah.
That's on the drugstore side.
Okay, this $9.99 concealer is proven that it's good. I love this. This is one of my favorite drugstore concealer. And it has full coverage, but it's still moisturizing. I don't know why I bought that bigger one. Because it's like 4-in-1, glowy, everything. Why not? Go to powder. And Catrice has a new product. This is Catrice True Skin Mineral Loose Powder. It's like the foundation that I like. And I tested this too for a week. And I know this is matte. That's why I will not use it all over my face. Because it will just dry me up. Because I have dry skin. But this is good for setting my under eyes.
It's a loose powder that's super fine, silky, and it has some ingredients that helps the skin be more naturally matte finish.
See, I'm not really into that matte finish because my skin is dry, so I will use another powder for the perimeter of my face, but this one is really good for setting the under eyes.
Yeah.
How much is it, honey?
$8? Bam! I would say that's on the drugstore side.
I like it. And even though it's matte, it doesn't dry my under eyes because that's my problem. I don't really have a dark circle, but I have a very dry under eyes. And this one doesn't crack up the concealer underneath.
Yeah.
And now we'll go to the powder that I will use all over my face. Mm. It's called Sisley Loose Face Powder with Hibiscus Flower Extract in color Irisy. This is $100.
That's on the drugstore side.
It's part of luxury side. And I chose this. Actually, this is not a setting powder. This is a finishing powder. But I want to use it as a setting powder today because I want to achieve that bronze goddess look that I keep on talking about, and it has like sheen that I like. So that's why I decided to use this for the perimeter of my face, and it doesn't lose the luminosity of the foundation. If I will have a top 5 powder, this is included.
Definitely
want, huh? All right, and now we're going to the face palette. And I bought this Anastasia Beverly Hills face palette. I bought the medium one. It's off to Costa Rica. And I chose this one because I know I want to do a bronze goddess look. And it has a name. The blush is called Hibiscus. The highlighter is called Sunset. And the bronzer is called Tamarindo. This is one of our first impressions. When I swatched it earlier, it's pigmented and it's dark. So I think I need to use a light hand on this. Remember what happened last time, honey?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely need to do that.
Okay.
It is a smooth powder formula. Melts into the skin for a natural skin kiss look. I like that. It's extremely blendable, soft texture with a lightweight feel and seamless finish. And it's $58, so not too bad considering. I would say that's not the drugstore side.
All right, so I'm done with the bronzer. It's not as dark as I swatch it. It really makes me look like bronze. Yeah. And this is the look that I am trying to create right now. And I think I'm on my way. Let's try the blush.
All right, the blush is smooth powder formula, melts in the skin for natural radiant color, extremely blendable, soft texture with a lightweight feel and seamless finish.
I'm done with the blush too, and oh my gosh, I love it. It is coral and like a hint of peach, and it's glowy. Oh, it's just right up in my alley. This is the vibe that I'm looking for. I can't wait to use the highlighter.
Highlighter, I love a highlighter.
This is the one that I think that I will not like because when I swatch it, it's too thick and too dark, but we'll see.
So the highlighter is luminous powder formula with ultra-fine pearls that deliver smooth, intense glow.
In the monitor, it looks good, but in real life, I feel like it doesn't highlight my skin. So I'll be back. I will get a highlighter that I like, okay? So I found the highlighter that I like that I think that will suit this bronze goddess look. And it's a drugstore. It's Juvia's Place Heroin Glow Highlighter. And it's True Golden Goddess with Juvia's Place Highlighters. And baked pressed highlighter is a mix of gold and bronze pearls that create iridescent finish. Let's try. Okay.
All right, $17.
See? And I'm nervous about this, so I will just use the one in the cap. Look how blinding it is. Just the cap.
Oh, wow.
I will use a light.
Looks like it's highlighting powder.
Oh, it's a loose highlighter, by the way. $17. And you know, it is available at Ulta, but if you're interested in picking it up, most of the time, Juvia's Place is making like a 30% discount on everything if you want to wait.
That's good.
I love this.
Yeah.
I'm glowing. This is the glow that I'm looking for on that palette. Well, that palette is how much, honey? $58?
Yeah, $58. And that highlighter is $17. I think the drugstore size win in this whole video competition.
No, this is $17 for just highlighter. This is three shades.
It's all right.
So, okay, I'm happy with this highlighter. Let's move to eyes. And this is the one that I'm really excited about, the Chanel. This is part of their summer collection, and this is in the shade 382. This is the gold one. I have both, but I choose to feature this one today because I'm looking for that bronze goddess look. And this is how it looks like. It has brushes that I will use. Since I have a hooded eye, this is an extra step for me, but this is not necessary, okay? It's just that I have a collection of Chanel. I will put the 804 cream as a base before I put this. Because this is not first impression for me. I already used this, and I already know how to make it pop and make it look like I'm a bronze goddess today. Just like what I said, this is an extra step. So this is part of the Chanel cream products. Actually, this is one and done shadow. Look, if you're a minimalist, you're already done with this. But I will just use it as a base because every cream makeup for me works because I have hooded eyes. And now we will start.
All right, this is a $62 product. It features a vibrant, pigment-rich formula in four tones, and it's inspired by threads of Chanel tweed. I don't know what the hell that means.
What is it called?
Lost for Hombres.
Okay, honey. It's French.
That sounds Spanish.
Oh, no.
Hombres?
No. It's Le Hombre.
Hey, I was going to throw on the sombrero, but maybe not. Throw some tacos on margaritas.
I'm doing my lower lash line and I'm using the Zoeva 230 Luxe Pencil. For my hooded eye, this is good. I love this pencil brush because I have small eyes. Okay, and Chanel came out with new eyeliners. It's a waterproof, and I have other Chanel eyeliners already that is waterproof, same like this, different colors, and I think they came out with 7 new, I'm not sure, but I pick up these two. It's called number 56, khaki metal, and number 54, rose curvy. And I think I want to use this khaki to define my outer eyelash. And unfortunately, when I look it up at Chanel today, it's out of stock, sold out. But I will still use it because I bought it. Sorry, guys. And now, this is the final look of the eyeshadow. And I love it, but I'm not happy about it because I didn't get the vibe that I want, like a bronze look. So I will top it off with this Illusion d'Ombre New Moon. And here it is. These cream products of Chanel is all $36. This is the lighter one that I used earlier, and this is New Moon that I will put as a topper of this eyeshadow. This eyeshadow is great. I love it. This is the formula that I will highly recommend for you to pick up on Chanel makeup line. But I have like a look that I am looking for, and since I have them all, why not use them? One of my favorite Chanel look. Oh, I will swatch it. How pretty it is. And I will just use it as a topper. Just like that. See the difference? Alright. Now, I feel like I'm bronze goddess.
That's nice.
I will just put eyeliner and lashes, and I'll be back for the lips. Okay, to finish this look, and for the lips, I will use this Chanel lip liner in shade 156, beige neutral. And it is $32.
Oh, looks nice. It's great on you.
Nude. And to finish the look, of course, I want some lipstick and Rouge Allure Luminous Intense Lip Color in shade 107 Beige. OR Beige. I love this. When I swatch it, it has like gold sparkle, and look how bougie this is. See? Chanel lipstick, nice.
Love that.
Packaging, logo, the best. How do you like it?
Wow, looks great on you. Yeah, very nice.
Okay. You can stop from there if you want, but because this lipstick has a luminous finish, you're okay without a gloss, but I want a gloss. So let's put some lip gloss. And I will use this. I'm debating which one I will use, my favorite Tom Ford or this Chanel top coat.
Oh, good.
I think I'll do this Tom Ford because I feel I'm too goldy already. But that's the one I want to look like, right? Bronze goddess. Just put it in the middle just to... Of course, if I want to look like a bronze goddess, I want to finish it with a shimmering oil. I have them both. The Tom Ford Soleil Edge and Soleil Blanc. And since I'm going to the bronze or gold look, we'll do this. It has a fragrance, and this is quite strong, by the way. Let's see. Oh, yeah. What do you think?
Yeah. Nice and wet. Smell good.
When you say it.
Wet and wild.
And to finish the look, I will spray with some Tatcha Luminous Dewy Skin Mist. By the way, this Tom Ford, I think, is $100. And this Tatcha is my favorite. Okay. How do you like this look?
Wow. Very nice. Very bronze.
This is my dream of being a bronze goddess. What do you think, you guys? Do you like my makeup? How I ended up? I love it. How I wish I will look like this every day, right? Okay, if you like this kind of videos, please don't forget to give us a like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. And don't forget to hit the notification bell so you'll be notified every time we will upload a video. And we want to hear your thoughts, guys. Give us ideas on what you want to see on our next videos. And we love you. See you in our next video. Bye.